There's one right there. Got me one.
Hopefully the snapper will see the crab waving along there.
That's a nice one, boys! Well, it's no secret that I like fishing, all forms of fishing, but I'm also a bit of a thrill seeker too. So a few years back, I combined the thrills and fishing and we came up with extreme fishing.
Whoa. Okay, here we go, guys. Here it goes, it's gonna break the surface, it's gonna jump right here. Whoa, whoa, whoa!
I'm trembling. That is a big marlin.
Oh, an animal.
Look at that! It's just about ripping my bloody arm off.
Whoa, 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 whoa! That's what I was talking about when I said it could go crazy at any moment.
It's all about extremely big fish.
That is a big marlin.
Extreme locations.
Oh no! Oh.
Extremely angry sharks.
Look at him!
Holy
That's a monster, mate.
And extreme fishing stunts.
Oh, no, he's coming here, he's coming here.
I don't know if this electric venture is going to be able to handle this.
Which leads me to now, the next form of extreme fishing. It's surf casting.
And it's extremely relaxing. And it can be extremely productive, so I'm told. You guys must have done this before. You guys haven't done it? Neither have I. It's about as long as I'm prepared to sit still. You want to take this, Leanne?
This is Leanne and Trish, the Bradley Smoker ladies. I'm going to leave them to their surf casting. And I'm going to go catch up with the boys over here because I've got something pretty interesting to show you. Now we're going to be setting out our Seahorse Electric Contacky off the beach, and it's the perfect thing for not only catching fish, but testing a bit of an experiment. Now what I've got here is our trace board. These traces are going to go onto the Contacky, and this is just a standard trace with a standard snapper longline hook. The next one here is a fluorocarbon trace. It's only 40 pound fluorocarbon, a smaller hook. The theory is that fluorocarbon is more invisible, so if the fish can't see it, you might catch more. The other theory is you want it to be more visible. So I've got this flasher rig here, and that makes it more visible to the fish and attracts them. So I've got the hooks alternating standard, fluorocarbon, and then flasher throughout the set. And what I'm going to be doing is baiting them up with just two baits. I'm going to be going mullet, and then squid on the next hook. So not only are the hooks alternating, the baits are alternating. Mullet, squid, and we're gonna record all of the information on here. Now throughout the course of the day in a whole bunch of sets, hopefully we'll catch some snapper, you'll learn a few tips, and we might just find out what makes these fish tick. So let's not muck around any longer, let's get these baits on and send this thing out there. Away she goes.
Woohoo!
Like a missile. Seahorse unit itself is just pulling out the line. I'm clipping on a sinker to keep it on the bottom, and then John's just going to pass me the hooks that are sort of alternating, and off they go out to sea, and hopefully they'll come back with some fish on them. Every four or five hooks I'm just clipping one of these on. It's got king salmon burley in it, and I'm just clipping it on, and that's just going to spread a little bit of burley up and down the line as it goes out to sea. On the very back I clip on a sinker that just keeps it all on the deck. And it's just going to head on out there and do its thing. It is getting heavy. It hasn't been out there that long. I wonder if it's sunk, mate.
Oh, no.
It's got a camera on it as well.
That'll be what happens.
I hope that camera's all right. Maybe like, we better pull it back in.
Yeah.
And maybe we might better find a few scallops on the way in if we're on the camera. Better check the camera out and see if we found a scallop bed. Actually, that's what we're trying to do. Find some scallops. Is there a fish coming up there? Well, it looks like it's the flasher with squid that caught us a fish.
Given that it's still quite lively, I might better just pop that hook out.
Needs to go and let this fella go. Off he goes. Perhaps it was the burley that attracted the barracuda. But then again, barracuda eat the same stuff as snapper, so.
Here it comes now. Hopefully we haven't killed that contiki. Oh, and the camera. Man, if that contiki's rigged, our day's over, bro.
Oh, hey, you made it back, buddy!
Now, we had a little bit of a mischief with the old seahorse here. It's probably a good lesson, and didn't have it set on properly. It filled up with water and it sank. Obviously not designed to be dragged along the sea floor. Here's the moment of truth to find out whether our day of fishing is over or not. Yee-oh! We're in business.
There's one right there. Got me one.
There's one crab. Hopefully the old snapper will see the crab waving along there on the bottom, getting dragged along by the contact. That's a nice one, boys!
We hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Now our special bait on the 25th hook for this set, one of these guys, a paddle crab. Now, of course, paddle crabs reside on sandy beaches just like this. There's been so many big snapper I've caught and found these in the guts, so it stood to reason that I'd get one for bait, and we went out last night and grabbed a few of these things. I'm just gonna peg these old snapper frames out into the surf line here, and the theory is that the old crabs will smell them, they'll come around to eat, pick the flesh off these, and I'll grab a hold of the crabs. And what I can use the crabs for is, of course, I could eat them if I wanted to, but even better, they make great snapper baits. Okay, now, this is always, this is the pointy end of it, is going out to the stake to see if there's any crabs hanging around there. Oh yeah, there's some big munty ones. Okay, now you can't always see what's going on, so quite often you've got to do this a little bit by feel. And when you're feeling for crabs, you sure know when you find one. Jeez, I hate doing this. There's one right there. Got me one. There's one crab. Did you see the big one there? There was a big hooah. Right, got me a crab here. Okay, where's that big hooah? Hey! Hey, you gotcha! Because look, did it draw blood, bro? It's all technique, isn't it?
Love it.
I think it could do with a bit of refinement, maybe a little bit less swell, but the system works. Now, to rig this guy up, I've got a bit of a bigger circle hook for our special hook. And I'm just going to pop one of the legs, the back legs off, just to make a sort of a hole. And I can go in through that hole, through that hard shell, and I can just sort of roll it around and come out the back paddle hole there. And that should grip in there just nicely, and hopefully the old snapper will see the crab waving along there on the bottom, getting dragged along by the contactor. We've got past our little operator error problem that we had, and we're going to whack it back out, this time for 10 minutes, which should take it about 800 or 900 metres out of the coast there. Okay, you ready, mate? Let her rip, mate! There she goes. Setting out there nicely. Now to get up and hook our chasers on.
spot.
Oh yeah, I like the idea of that burley going out there. And of course, as it's being dragged along, all that salmon burley should be coming out.
Oh, and here's our special bait at the end.
The old paddle crab.
Away he goes.
Third time, the rain closed in and the wind picked up. While it's not quite as balmy anymore, a front like this often brings the fish on the bite. So, we decided to fish on. Besides, we're conducting an important experiment that has to be completed.
This is the bit that we all like, is the retrieve. Oh yes, that's a nice fish, and quite surprisingly, it's a dark sort of kelpie coloured fish. Beautiful eating size, I mean, perfect sort of size for the smoker. Stunning fish, and it looks like he was taken just on the standard trace with no flasher. What do we got there, snapper? Another standard trace with mullet. That's a stunning looking fish. Should have some good fat on it. Just those beautiful oils that all just go bloody beauty. It's the new Level Wine model Seahorse. Well, as you can see, John's operating the winch and just unclipping the traces by himself. If I can demonstrate, you just sort of hold the switch on. When you let it go, it turns off.
Things can go pear-shaped if you use the on all the time. It's the only thing you should use.
John knows this. It's because when he was operating this very Contiki on this very beach, he had it switched to on. A trace came up, hooked John through the hand and dragged his hand into the winch, which unfortunately for you, mate, we got photos of that.
Oh dear.
And even more unfortunately, we're going to have to show them to our viewers, because really we have to demonstrate how not to do it and that, you know, what can go wrong. But you see, I mean, you've learned, you're doing it just perfectly now. Yeah, what have we got here? Oh yeah! Woo! That's what I'm talking about. Got them on the old tour tour, eh? Freshly dug tour tours on the special. Actually a genuine stingray. Okay, what we've got here, and it is a fairly common bycatch on Contikis, is the stingray. Now of course, we're all aware of these things, stingray, and this is the end that we've got to be careful of. Right down here, that little barb there, they can thrust that into you, and there's a poison neurotoxin coated on that barb there, and you can see he's a little bit twitchy. I don't want to upset him because I don't want him to stab me with that, but I am going to try and just roll that hook out and get him into the water. Too often you see people surf casting or with contikis that catch these guys and they just leave them up on the sand to die because they're afraid of them. If you stay up this end, they can't really hurt you too much. Look, I've just rolled that hook out. I'm just going to get our little mate back into the water, because while he might freak a lot of people out, he still has his part to play in the marine ecosystem, so we're just going to get him out there. Our little wee stingray mate, there he goes. Oh, don't stab me with your barb, buddy. Look at him, he's waving his barb around there. He's defending himself. Away he goes. But look what we've got here. Oh, mate, that's a nice one. That's a nice one for the Contiki. And of course, we're dying to see what we got him on. Just the standard. Standard with mullet. That's a nice one, boys! That last one that you saw was a stingray. This guy here is an eagle ray. You can tell quite different, much pointier wings. not only do you have to be careful of the barb when you're releasing these guys, you've got to be careful you don't get water over the top of your red bands. Can inflict a nasty bit of water, get cold feet, so you can end up with the flu. And away he goes. Come on, buddy. Away you go. Away you go, bud. Away you go. Just encouraging him. Just encouraging him, making sure he goes out the right way. I'm still excited about that big snapper on the Contiki. Well, we've got a few snapper in there now on ice, along with the kahawai, and everyone around here is starting to smack their lips because they're hungry for a feed of fresh fish. So we're going to take this lot back and process them, and the Bradley girls reckon they can whip up a pretty mean feed of snapper in their Bradley smoker. Well, of course, one of the main reasons for going and getting fish is to eat it. And one of my favourite ways of having fish is, of course, is smoked fish. But I'm just going to, for this fish here, I'm just going to take the fillets off, and I've got a, geez, that's a lovely knife, that's a Rapala filleting knife. And I'm just going to whack these fillets off because we all love a feed of fresh snapper, just sort of fried up. I've got a bit of Fog Dog Easy Beer Batter that I'm going to mix up and shallow fry these fillets. But I'm going to see if I can use as much of this fish as possible and whack it in the old smoker behind me here, and we'll hopefully end up with some beautifully smoked fish. Get the center line of bones out. I'm not going to throw that away, I'm going to keep that. And we end up with a couple of beautiful fillets there. I'm going to send those off. They're off to the kitchen to be cooked. While a lot of people would throw that away, I'm getting this ready for the smoker. And the first thing I'm going to do is take the wings off. Beautiful. Look at all that meat, hey? Why would you want to throw that out? This is what we're left with now, the backbone. The sweetest meat is closest to the bone. That's all this stuff here. We can just take that off the head just by going through that vertebrae there. That's ready to go into the smoker as well. And lo and behold, the fish head. Everyone loves fish heads, don't they? You can see there's been a bit of flavour sort of build up in the smoker over the years. I've actually caught it on fire twice and part of the fence, which I had to replace, but that's a different story. I'll have to chop up a bit of wood, kick the fire in the guts, and then what I've got to do is apply the precise amounts of heat and smoke to this fish to make it edible. Piece of cake.
I hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.